ठीक है।
Hi everyone, I am Mahadevgad, Department of Botany. After the lockdown, the remaining BSC for 6M contain the plant propagation. The plant propagation is already known in the previous classes. In plant propagation, first one definition, the plants propagation involves the formation and the development of new individuals which are used in exhibit of new planting. Okay, the propagules produces new plants. Propagules produces new plants in the vegetative propagation. Okay, next, another one, the methods of vegetative propagation. There are three methods of vegetative propagation. One is cutting, and another one is layering, and another one is grafting. Okay, these are the three methods in plant propagation for improving the crop varieties, and another one, horticulture and ornamental plant development. Okay, next, another one is cutting method. Very important. You are already known in agricultural development using cutting methods. The next is spring and autumn season. In the spring and autumn season, mainly spring season, okay, and autumn period, by using the cutting methods, it's a suitable period for the cutting methods. We're already known about in sugar cane and rose plantation. A sugar cane and rose plantation, you take the plant and cut into the small pieces, okay, at suitable period, okay, soil, moist or nutrient soils, okay, after its suitable period and the conditions of nutrients, it will be developed. Next, another one, these eyes or small pieces, propagules, these propagules are stored in indole butyric acid. We already know about some chemical substances. Okay, the chemical substance are used in cutting method for storage purpose. IBA, indole butyric acid, and another one, indole acetic acid. Okay, these are the major chemical for the storage the propagules. Yes, what are the propagules? Propagules are the small pieces. These propagules are developed into the new individual as parent, because it is in these propagules the development mitotic cycle takes place. No variations will be occur as parent as it should be developed. Next, another one, some hormones. The hormonal powders are used in cutting method because some plants are low growth. Okay, that's why using some chemicals, hormones are used. Hormones, okay. What are major hormones? Auxin. Auxin powder is used in the cutting method. Okay. Next, another one. Okay. Not only the sugar cane, even potato. Yes. Another one in roots and leaves. For example, in the bryophyllum leaves are used as a propagules. The single leaves, it is an example for leaf vegetative propagule. The small leaves are developed at the notches or ridges or side of the bryophyllum leaves. These leaves are cut, they are separate. These separation of leaves are developed into the new bryophyllum plant. Okay, it is a cutting methods. After, next, another one, layering method. It is a second method of plant propagation. This method, layering methods, there are two types of layering methods. One is air layering methods and another one is stool layering methods. Commonly, in take some rooted plant and remove the skin, outer stem skin, and another one wrap with polythene. Ok, Okay, and another one, before the polythene, using some mud. This mud is used in the air layering method. It is a famous, widely accepted method, air layering method, because it is an easily developed. And another one, a single plant is developed into the multiplied or new inducibles by booting method. This air layering or booting methods, it's widely accepted. And another one, it's developed in horticulture media. Next, another one, stool layering method. Take for example in lemon plant, yes, since or citrus plant, that take a plant or tree, plant tree, and another one down the plant tree and immerse into the soil. After 3 to 4 months, the small roots are developed in this region. After the roots are development, it's cut into separate these branches, and these branches are developed into the new inducibles. This technology been developed after the cutting methods. Okay, next, another one. This stool layering method is an improving horticulture media and fruits development and ornamental plants development. Okay, next, another one, grafting. Okay, grafting, it is an third plant propagation method. It is a very important method. Okay, in this grafting technology, there are two types. One is approach grafting and another one is side grafting. Okay, side grafting and approach grafting. This the grafting technology, the first one, approach technology, we using two plants, okay, the stems are contact with each other, two plant stems are contact with each other, and another one, it bind with each other, and another one, after 3 to 4 months, okay, 3 to 4 months, it's developed into the new plants. It is helpful for the increasing the resistance, and also transfer the resistance power in the approach grafting method. It is also one of the major method in grafting technology. Next, in the grafting technology, yes, wet grafting method, there are two parts are there. One is CR and another one is stalk, very important in examination purpose. What is CR and what is stalk? Stalk is nothing but, it is a rooted plant. Okay, it is a rooted plant, it is helpful for the development of the CR. And another one is stalk. This stalk is helpful for and provide the nutrition and provide the water. Next, another one, CR. CR is a transported plant. Okay, is there any other varieties of plant body? These plants are similar in same species. Okay, this CR, for example, in wet grafting method, okay, is used a single plant, mango plant. Okay, is there a single mango plant? This single mango plant having different varieties, produces different varieties of fruits in a single tree. Okay, in single tree, mango tree produces different varieties of fruits. Okay, grafting methods is an input for the this process. Okay, the various fruits are developed in a single plant. Okay, it is a simple explanation about plant propagation.